What is blood pressure? What is hypertension? How do we treat hypertension? What is the classification of hypertension? This and more in the video to come. Have fun and enjoy. The blood pressure is the pressure of blood on the atrial walls. When we talk about blood pressure, it would be shown in two numbers. For example, 120 millimeters of mercury and 70 millimeters of mercury. The first number is expressed in terms of the systolic blood pressure, and the second number is the diastolic pressure. Since 2017, the American Heart Association considers optimal blood pressure to be lower than 120 to 80 millimeters of mercury. Systolic blood pressure is the maximal pressure in the arteries at the moment of pushing the blood into the aorta during the ventricular contractions. Systolic blood pressure mainly depends on the volume of blood ejected into the aorta, so-called the stroke volume, and it also depends on heart rate. The heart rate is the number of heartbeats per minute. You can also define it as the speed of which the heart beats. So, heart rate multiplied by stroke volume is called cardiac output. The cardiac output is usually expressed in liters per minute. So in other words, the cardiac output is simply the amount of blood pumped by the heart per minute. It is the product of the heart rate, which is the number of beats per minute, and the stroke volume, which is the amount pumped per beat. The diastolic blood pressure is specifically the minimum atrial pressure during relaxation of the ventricles when the ventricles fill with blood. Diastolic blood pressure mainly depends on total peripheral vascular resistance. The increased vascular resistance is mainly attributable to small arteries and arterioles. Difference between systolic and diastolic blood pressure is called pulse pressure. For example, if blood pressure is 120 to 80 millimeters of mercury, then the pulse pressure is 40 millimeters of mercury. Pulse pressure depends on the interaction of stroke volume and the ability of arteries to expand, also called compliance. Reduced atrial compliance causes the elevation of the pulse pressure, which often is found in elderly patients. Now, as we have talked about the physiology of blood pressure, let's talk about hypertension, also known as high blood pressure. Hypertension is a long-term patient's condition which is characterized by persistent elevation of atrial blood pressure. Usually, patient with hypertension complains of headache, nausea, and fatigue. Also, hypertension-associated complaints involve blurred vision or loss of vision, chest pain, irregular heartbeat, mental disorders, ringing in the ears. In 90% of patients, the cause of hypertension is unknown. This is called primary or essential hypertension, which is a multifactorial disease. The risk factors of primary hypertension include obesity, high sodium intake, sympathetic activity, stress, old age, and family history. But sometimes the causes of hypertension are found. These are most often underlying, reversible causes. It is called secondary hypertension. The causes of secondary hypertension include renal artery stenosis due to atherosclerosis or fibromuscular dysplasia, vasculitis, kidney disease, pheochromocytoma, hyperaldosteronism, Cushing's syndrome, hyperthyroidism, hypothyroidism, acromegaly, hyperparathyroidism, coarcation of the aorta, obesity, excessive drinking of alcohol, obstructive sleep apnea, pregnancy, drugs such as oral contraceptive pill, immunosuppressive medications, stimulant drugs, nasal decongestants, corticosteroids, and caffeine. High blood pressure in pregnancy is classified in three types: pre-existing hypertension, gestational hypertension, and pre-eclampsia. Gestational hypertension is defined as new onset hypertension during pregnancy without protein in the urine. Preeclampsia is defined when a pregnant woman has high blood pressure and has protein in the urine. Preeclampsia can be complicated by a life-threatening condition called eclampsia, which is a hypertensive emergency with seizures and proteinuria. So there are differences in the definition of hypertension between the European Society of Cardiology and the American College of Cardiology. According to the European Society of Cardiology, blood pressure is classified as optimal, normal, high normal, grade 1 hypertension, grade 2 hypertension, grade 3 hypertension, and isolated systolic hypertension. Optimal blood pressure means blood pressure that is less than 120 to 80 millimeters of mercury. Normal blood pressure denotes systolic blood pressure of 120 to 129 millimeters of mercury and or diastolic blood pressure of 80 to 84 millimeters of mercury. High normal blood pressure means systolic blood pressure of 130 to 139 millimeters of mercury and or diastolic blood pressure of 85 to 89 millimeters of mercury. If blood pressure is 140 to 90 millimeters mercury and more, on two or more occasions, hypertension is diagnosed. Grade 1 hypertension means systolic blood pressure of 140 to 159 millimeters of mercury and diastolic pressure of 90 to 99 millimeters of mercury. Grade 2 hypertension is diagnosed when systolic blood pressure ranges from 160 to 179 millimeters of mercury and or diastolic pressure ranges from 100 to 109 millimeters of mercury. If systolic blood pressure is 180 millimeters of mercury and more, and or diastolic hypertension is 110 millimeters of mercury and more, grade 3 hypertension is diagnosed. An isolated systolic hypertension is diagnosed if systolic blood pressure is 140 millimeters of mercury and more, and diastolic blood pressure is less than 90 millimeters of mercury. The isolated systolic hypertension is graded 1, 2, or 3 according to systolic blood pressure. Also, home blood pressure monitoring and ambulatory blood pressure monitoring can establish a diagnosis. According to the American College of Cardiology, blood pressure is classified as normal, elevated, stage 1 hypertension, stage 2 hypertension. Normal blood pressure means blood pressure is less than 120 to 80 millimeters of mercury. Elevated blood pressure denotes systolic blood pressure of 120 to 129 millimeters of mercury and or diastolic blood pressure less than 80 millimeters of mercury. Stage 1 hypertension is diagnosed when systolic blood pressure ranges from 130 to 139 millimeters of mercury and or diastolic pressure ranges from 80 to 89 millimeters of mercury. If systolic blood pressure is 140 millimeters of mercury and more and or diastolic hypertension is 90 millimeters of mercury and more, stage 2 hypertension is diagnosed. Currently, there is no single mechanism that can explain the pathology of the essential hypertension. Activation of the renin-angiotensin's aldosterone system is considered to be a major theory of essential hypertension. Juxtaglomerular cells release renin in response to a decrease in afferent arterial pressure. Reduce sodium chloride delivery to macula densa and increase sympathetic tone. Renin cleaves a decapeptide angiotensin 1 from angiotensinogen. Angiotensin 1 is transformed in angiotensin 2 by the angiotensin converting enzyme, also called ACE, which is synthesized mainly in the lungs. Angiotensin 2 is the strongest vasoconstructive factor. Besides direct vasoconstructive effect, it causes aldosterone release in the adrenal cortex leading to the sodium and fluid retention and potassium excretion and impaired endothelial cell function. Also, angiotensin II causes the release of vasopressin, exhibiting reabsorption of water in the kidneys, and it has vasoconstructive effects. Also, vasopressin enhances the sensation of thirst. Angiotensin II stimulates sodium-hydrogen exchangers, increasing a sodium reabsorption. All these mechanisms lead to an increase in both blood volume and vascular tone, resulting in elevated blood pressure. Increased cardiac output and heart rate influences blood pressure much less than vascular resistance, but they can cause the borderline hypertension in young people. Another mechanism of the blood pressure elevation is based on abnormal cell membrane ion transport, resulting in an increase in the intracellular calcium, which increases vascular tone and stimulates hypertrophy. Endothelial dysfunction also plays an important role in blood pressure elevation. The endothelial cell has impaired biosynthesis or release of the nitric oxide and an increased vasoconstrictive response to endothelial. According to the European Society of Cardiology, there are three stages of hypertension. Stage 1, uncomplicated, stage 2, an asymptomatic disease with hypertension-mediated organ damage, stage 3, established cardiovascular or renal disease. Asymptomatic hypertension-mediated organ damage involves the following states: left ventricular hypertrophy, microalbuminuria or elevation of albumin-creatinine ratio, chronic kidney disease, retinopathy, ankle brachial index less than 0.9, and signs of atrial stiffening. Established cardiovascular diseases associated with hypertension include ischemic stroke, cerebral hemorrhage, transitory ischemic attack, myocardial infarction, angina, myocardial revascularization, and atheromatous plaque on imaging, heart failure, peripheral artery disease, and atrial fibrillation. Lifestyle modifications should be advised for every patient presenting with blood pressure of 130 to 80 millimeters of mercury and more. Lifestyle modifications involve weight normalization, reduced sodium intake, DASH diet, increased physical activity, relief from emotional stresses, avoiding of excessive alcohol and caffeine consumption, cessation of smoking, adequate intake of calcium and magnesium. If blood pressure exceeds 140 to 90 millimeters of mercury, an antihypertensive drug therapy should be initiated. An initial two-drug combination is preferred for most patients. The dual combination of ACE inhibitors, angiotensin receptor blockers, calcium channel blockers, diuretic, should be included into initial therapy. Combination of ACE and angiotensin receptor blockers may be harmful due to the risk of hyperkalemia and renal failure. If dual therapy fails, the triple combination should be used. If the three-drug therapy at the maximum tolerated dose isn't effective, spironolactone and other diuretics, beta blockers or alpha blocker may be added. Beta blockers may be used at any step when there are special indications such as heart failure, angina, history of myocardial infarction, atrial fibrillation. It is recommended that the first objective of treatment should be to lower blood pressure to less than 140 to 90 millimeters of mercury in all patients who tolerate this. But the main target is 130 to 80 millimeters of mercury or lower for most patients. Diastolic blood pressure target is 80 millimeters of mercury and less. It's important that the systolic blood pressure should not be lowered below 120 millimeters of mercury. Carotid baroreceptor stimulation, renal denervation, and creation of an arteriovenous fistula are not recommended because currently there is no evidence regarding their safety and efficacy.